You are going to know so much more about Back for Blood by the time we're done with this video. In fact, let me go ahead and fix something for you. Let me showcase something that I know you're curious about. Let's take all these weapons here, right? Let's take a look at the fire axe. So we have a gray fire axe here. And, well, how much damage does it do? Well, let's go test it. If we come over here, we hit this guy, but bam! It does 85 damage per swing. Okay, cool. But what about the green fire axe or the blue one? Or the purple one? Well, don't you worry. I got you covered today, fam. Take a look at what we found. Courtesy of Statty.net and then also the Back for Blood Discord. Let's dive deep into what we got here, okay, chat? So, let's just get started right away. We have every single weapon in the game. And then not only do we have every single weapon in the game, we also have every single rarity of every single weapon in the game. Also, we have the RPM, we have the bullet penetration, and we have how much it scales per level, and what the damage drop-off is. This is incredible. I love this whole website. So, there's some things about this that I think will be really interesting to you, because not only do you have these numbers here, there's some patterns behind these numbers that I think you might really, really like to see, which will help inform your decision-making as you're building out your character. So, let's go ahead and just pop right into that here. If you go ahead and you take a look at the M4, I think a lot of people feel like the M4 is like, meh, it doesn't do that much damage, it's bleh. Well, let's take a look here. The gray version of the M4 does 10 damage, you can see that here. Here, let me try to zoom in a little bit. Is that getting any larger? Yeah, let's just do it like this. So it says 10 damage on the gray one, 11.5 on the green one, 13.2 and 15.2. Now there is a pattern here, and most of these weapons follow a pattern. Okay? So let me bust out the calculator here and showcase to you what it is I'm talking about with these patterns. Because these make a really, really big difference as the game develops. So what you'll see here is you have 10 damage, right? And then you have 11.5 damage. So let's go ahead and see what exactly that means. How much of an increase is that? 11.5 divided by 10. What you get here is a 15% increase in damage between gray to green. Okay? Now let's go ahead and try it from blue to green. So we'll do 13.2, because that's what it says here, 13.2 divided by 11.5. And what you'll see, again, is it's about a 15% increase. And then let's do it one more time, 15.2 divided by 13.2. And what you'll get here is a 15% increase. So, why this matters so much is that not all of these weapons are created equal. Some of them have much bigger jumps than others. And because of that, by the time a weapon is purple, it might catch up a little bit more as opposed to when it was gray compared to other weapons. A good example of this is the ranch rifle. Everybody knows by now that the ranch rifle's pretty good straight out the gate. You pick that thing up and it's doing 22 damage as a gray variant. But by the time it's a purple, it's doing 29.3, which you can see here, right? Now, the big kicker with that is that it is only 10% in between each level. So if you go ahead and you see, what does it say here, 24.2, so 24.2 divided by 22, what you'll get here is a 10% increase. And something to keep note here is that it goes 10% more than the previous level. So if I go 22 here, and then I multiply that 1.1 to get that 10%, that's how I get 24.2, right? Well, if I do that same base number that I had, multiply it by 10 again, and now it's 26.2. So you take the 10%, and then you multiply it by 10%, and then you multiply it by 10%. So it kind of gets exponentially larger. But the thing to note here is that, take a look. This M4 starts at a 10, right? And then the ranch rifle starts at a 22. So if you take 22 divided by 10, you'll see that it's 2.2 times better per bullet. It's 2.2 times stronger per bullet. However, let's take the purple variants here. So let's take 29.3 on the ranch rifle and then go 15.2 on the M4. And what you'll see is that it's no longer 2.2 times stronger. Instead, it's only 1.92. So it loses its advantage as the rarity goes up. And this becomes an extremely big deal on some of these other weapons. For example, the ump. Take a look at, you can just look at the lines. You don't even have to sit here and listen to my numbers. Look at the lines and how much it jumps. Now, a lot of these weapons have a consistent climb, right? So when I was talking about the M4, it goes 15%, 15%, 15%. Well, they're not all created equal. Most of them follow a set thing, but some of them don't. For example, the Barrett. Let's go find the Barrett. The Barrett's really exciting, right? So the purple version of the Barrett does 225 damage, and then the gray version does 120 damage. And to be clear, these are body shots. This is not weak spot damage. This is not bonus weak spot damage. This is just a straight up body shot. So if you start weak spotting any of these things, oh my God, that gets even more crazy. But let's just talk about the body shot damage that we see here. So you know how I said it goes 10, 10, 10 on the Ranch Rifle, 15, 15, 15 on the M4? Well, it doesn't do quite the same thing on the Barrett. So the Barrett here does 144. You divide that by 120, right? What you get is a 20% increase because you have 1.2. However, the difference between the blue and the green is different. So if you go 180 divided by 144, you'll actually get a 25% increase. And then the final one is also a 25% increase because you go 225 divided by 180, you'll get yourself another 25% increase. So it gets even better as it gets even better. And then the ump is even more crazy because the ump here, it starts off at... Let me see. It starts off at 13 damage, and it climbs all the way up to 24.4, and you can see that these are not linear climbs. Like, these, the jump between green to blue is humongous. The jump between blue to purple is humongous, but the jump from gray to green isn't so big. So, to really showcase how much more damage you're doing, so 24.4 on the ump here divided by 13. So what's a purple versus a gray? This gun becomes 87% stronger, almost 88% stronger from gray to purple, which is huge. But if you go ahead and you take a look at something like the Ranch Rifle going from gray to purple, and this might even help you feel a little bit more comfortable with a lower tier version of the Ranch Rifle. But if you go from a Ranch Rifle, you're only going to get yourself an increase of 33%. You see that? Because 29.3 divided by 22, that's only a 33% increase. See why this matters so much? Some of these guns really, really benefit from this, and others not so much. The UMP is one of those that really, really benefits from it. The Barrett, I think, also really, really benefits. What was it, 225 divided by 120? That is 87.5% stronger. That's a huge increase. Humongous. Not all of these are created equal. Like, take a look at this thing. The Tech 9 doesn't change that much. I mean, it is a big percentage, don't get me wrong. It's still like 30%. But it's nothing like the freaking 87% that we get on some of these other weapons here from gray to purple. So this is just really up to you if you'd like to remember these things. Look at the TAC. Look at how much strong the TAC increases its damage by almost 100%. It's almost a complete doubling from gray to purple. And again, the Ranch Rifle is only 30% stronger. 100% versus 30%. So I encourage you, go weapon by weapon and look at these. Look at the ones that you like picking, and then look at the ones that you're like, huh, I never really thought about that one before, but now maybe I'm thinking about it. Like, something else that blows my mind about this. Take a look. If you just want to go real basic, oh, damage does number. Take a look. The AK-47 here does 24.2 damage per shot, and it fires at a rate of 600 RPM. Has 20 bullets, and it takes 3.23 seconds to reload. Now, let's go ahead and look at the UMP. The UMP fires at the same rate of fire, has the same amount of bullets, takes less time to reload, and it does more damage. Now, other things to note, its bullet penetration is not as strong, and it does drop off on its damage a little bit faster than the AK does. But if you're sitting here in nightmare mode and you're trying to optimize for who has what, like somebody's only running SMG, well, suddenly the UMP looks really, really strong, doesn't it? Somebody's only running AR, well, then they can pick one of those ARs. If somebody's running sniper, well, take a look at how much these things climb. It's remarkable. Like, the Phoenix kind of blows when you take a look at how much it could grow. compared to the Barrett here. Isn't that nuts? Isn't this incredible? Huh! On top of that, oh, you thought I was done? You're like, oh, okay, cool. He looked at numbers. That's such a sweet video swing point. Oh, by the way, take a look at the bat. Take a look at the machete. Take a look at the axe. Where's the axe? The axe climbs at a rate of 30% per level. So your green axe is 30% stronger. Your blue axe is 30% stronger than your green axe. And your purple axe is 30% stronger than your blue axe. So at the end of the day, your purple axe... Your purple axe is over double the damage of the gray axe. Over double! 120% increase! And again, the ranch rifle, from gray to purple, is only a 30% increase. So look real deeply at all of this and see how big some of these gaps get and see how even they are, or uneven, etc., etc. Now, like I said, you thought I was done? I'm not done! So now let's go ahead and take a look at how this gets even more cool. Now, we got a good idea of how much damage we do to body shots here, right? And I've also talked about weak spot damage in my other video about how damage actually works in this game. So take these numbers and start mathing these out with your cards however you want. But where you're really going to gain a lot of power is knowing how much health the Ridden have. This is really, really cool. So we have numbers here on this statty.net website of the common... on their ferocious status and their monstrous status. We can check it on survivor and we can check it on nightmare. We see the mutations are different between veteran and nightmare. There's also swarm here as well. The weak point multiplier, I'm going to challenge that because I don't think this really paints the full picture as to how much the weak point does. That's my asterisk here. Based off of what I found with weak spot damage, this is not entirely how you would explain it. So I would pay attention to the HP numbers here, and then maybe there'll be more in-depth stuff about the bonus weak spot versus the multiplier within the base damage, blah, 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 blah. I talked about a lot of that in the other video we did. But just take a look at the numbers here. That's the really interesting part. So let's go to Nightmare, and then you can see how much you hit these guys for. So you can really start mathing this out, right? You can see exactly how much HP one of these dudes has at whatever monstrous, ferocious, whatever they are, on whatever difficulty, and then you can go back to the damage charts here and be like, okay, this is how many bullets I need. And then if you really want to get mathy about it, you can go ahead and go, well, I have weak spot damage of plus 50%. I have these attachments on my weapon. I have, you know, glass cannon here, hyper focus there, silver bullets here, and really start to do this all mathy, and then you can be like, well, what if I hit him in the weak spot with the bonus damage and yada hada? You're gonna go ahead and really be able to be absolutely precise about what it takes to take down one of these Ridden. I guarantee you, with this information, you're going to be able to figure out how to one-shot things that you never knew how to do before. You're going to be able to look at this stuff and be like, I know exactly what they're capable of. I know exactly what I need to do, and I know exactly what I'm capable of in order to help my team out the most. So, again, statty.net is what this is called. If you do want to be a part of these discussions and talk with me and play with me and do viewer games and all that type of jazz, we do stream every single night on twitch.tv/swingpoint. I'd love to see you guys over there. Also, please consider subscribing if these videos have been helpful to you at all. And go check out this website. The link is in the description down below. Thank you guys so much. You guys are awesome. And I'll see you in the next video that we do around here.